You are a web developer. You're building web apps and you probably need to handle data. You need a database, you just don't know it yet. It's 2025. Let's use Keentone, a free online database. It's fully featured and we can set it up in 1 minute. Let's try it right now. So we're going to sign up for Keentone. Right now, go to keentone.dev/new and you're going to get this developer's license registration form. The gist of it is, please don't spam API calls, and in return, you have a free online web database. And I really mean free, as in we don't sell your information. You don't need a credit card or anything to sign up. It's not freemium. Scroll down right here. Give us your first name. My name's Sean, and my email. And if you give us a little bit of information about yourself, that's always nice. I love Keentone workshops and YouTube videos. Check them out. Right here, you can make your Keentone subdomain. The subdomain is going to be what comes before .keentone.com. So we're going to make test for Keentone. There we go. And click sign up. Follow some captchas so you can make sure you're not a robot. All right, I'm not a robot. Thank you. You're going to get an email from the Keentone Developer Program. It's going to look like this. Scroll down, click on activate now to get ask for a password. Pick a password. Password. Set the password. Once you've chosen your password, you will be at a login screen. Your login username is going to be your email that you use to sign up, and your password will be the password that you just chose. Enter that in and click on Keentone, and welcome to your brand new Keentone domain. With your new Keentone portal, you can make a web database in seconds with drag and drop. Click on the plus sign, click on create app from scratch. What kind of app are we going to make? Customer database. Sure, why not? What do customers have? They have names, so we're going to drag in a text field here, call it name, just so we know what it is. And if we want to access it with code later on via API, give it a field code of name. And what else do customers have? Maybe they made an order with us, and so we need to save their invoice as a PDF, as an attachment, and maybe I need to know what time I need to pay that invoice by, so we're going to add in a date field. And lastly, let's see, we can see who created this information and when it was created automatically with a created by and created date time field. Go up to the top right, click on activate app, okay, and you have created a database with five columns, just like that. Now that you have your Keentone web database set up, we could manually enter information into our database. Click on this plus sign right here, and you can see that we get a form so that anyone can enter information, but we're developers. We want API tokens. If you click on this cogwheel for settings up in the top right, and click on the app settings tab, scroll down to API token, and you can see that we have a screen to generate API tokens. Click on generate, and you can get an API token. You can scope it with permissions, and click on save right down here on the right, and don't forget to click on update app, and you will see that we have created a web database with information, API token, and authentication in less than 1 minute. Now that you have your free Keentone web database, you need to know how to use its REST API. You can go to keentone.dev for all of our API documentation with our REST API. We have cool tutorials, and if you ever have questions, click on forum up here in the top right, and you have our Keentone Developers Forum, where us Keentone devs will answer all of your questions that you post here. Good luck.